Good morning, church. Here we are, Philippians 1. We're going to talk about verses 1 and 2. And really, you know, when we talked about that in the message, I told you that we need to be rooted in Christ because what Christ has done for us is foundational. And in Philippians, the big idea that Paul's talking about is rejoicing. And so here in the first couple of verses, what I want you to see is really just the focus on Christ. And then also just think about who he's writing to. So here's the text. Paul and Timothy, servants of Christ Jesus, to all the saints in Christ Jesus who are at Philippi, with the overseers and the deacons, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. And so what Paul is doing is he's with Timothy. Timothy's like his companion. They're going out. They're sharing the gospel. And first of all, just if you get your Bible, you could underline how many times he says Christ Jesus, and that's important. Christ is foundational to everything we do. Our joy comes, it originates from Jesus Christ. Secondly, just to think about while you're there studying and trying to go deeper, overseers and deacons, right? Two offices. In our churches, modern churches, we talk about pastors and deacons. The word pastor is like not really used in the New Testament. Shepherd is used like once, but usually you hear elders and overseers, and these are like the leaders in churches, and you hear deacons. Deacons are like servants in the office. And then he writes also to all of the saints that are in Christ Jesus. So what Paul is really doing is he's saying, hey, I'm writing to the church in Philippi. And so maybe a couple questions for us to think about as we ponder and study elders, overseers, deacons, saints. What does that mean? Questions. Do you ever think about yourself as a saint? Because everybody who's in Christ Jesus is a saint. A saint is a holy one. So if you think of yourself as a saint, or if you don't, comment about that. And what does it mean to be saintly? Maybe another question to think about, why is Christ foundational? Like, why does it matter more than anything else that Christ is our foundation in our joy and in our lives?